So this morning, a News 8 follow-up. In 1998, News 8 took you on board the SS United States. The historic ocean liner was sitting in a dock in Philadelphia in deteriorating condition. At that time, an effort was underway to fix up the huge vessel and restore it to its former glory. Now, 14 years later, the SS United States still sits in that Philadelphia dock. It's still in bad shape, and there's a new effort underway to restore it. This morning, we take you back on board a marvel of American engineering that some hope can still be saved.
Up Lower Broadway from the Battery to City Hall, the officers and men of the Superliner United States were given the kind of welcome New York reserves only for its heroes.
In 1952, the SS United States was one of the biggest news stories in the world. Made completely in America, it broke the transatlantic speed record on its maiden voyage, taking only 3 days, 10 hours, and 40 minutes to travel from the U.S. to the United Kingdom. It was a majestic symbol of a country that had established itself as a world superpower.
This ship absolutely epitomized made in America. It was the perfect ship. It was the best. It was the fastest. It was incredible.
It's been 60 years since the SS United States made that historic first voyage, and the fortunes of the ship have fallen as the decades have passed. Jetliners replaced ships for overseas travel, and in 1969, the United States was taken out of service. Since 1996, the giant ocean liner has sat here at Pier 84 in South Philadelphia, across the street from an IKEA. And the years have not been kind to our country's namesake vessel.
When you see the ship in this condition, what goes through your mind?
What happened? Why? Why is it like this?
For former passengers like Rosalind McPherson, the current state of the ship is heartbreaking. What was once a gleaming modern marvel is now faded and rusty, with peeling paint its most prominent feature. In 1994, the ship was gutted, leaving almost no trace of the former luxury. But despite its current condition,
she just needs some fresh makeup.
There are a growing number of supporters,
some paint,
who want to remember the history of this vessel.
Should be back in business.
And reclaim its glory.
We, in this country, we built it here. No other country has ever been able to duplicate this. Even with atomic power today, she's a marvel, and it should be preserved.
The SS United States was unique from the very start. It was a joint venture. The U.S. government wanted a large, fast vessel that could be used by the military if necessary, capable of transporting large numbers of soldiers. So the government paid for $50 million of the $78 million price tag. The rest was covered by the ship's operators, United States Lines.
While censorship forbids revealing details of her lower hull construction, it is no secret that the new liner possesses structural strength and features for safety unknown in shipbuilding even a few short years ago.
The ship was the brainchild of engineer William Francis Gibbs, whose revolutionary design included using aluminum instead of steel to make the ship lighter and faster.
My grandfather loved the ship.
Gibbs' granddaughter now heads up the restoration effort.
It was a dream he had from when he was a boy. He wanted to design the fastest ship in the world.
And he did. But even the SS United States hasn't been able to outrun Father Time. The question now, can it be saved?
Right now, this is merely the shell of what it once was. I just can't believe that it came to this.
And our reports on the SS United States continue tomorrow morning. We'll talk with former passengers and crew members about their memories of the ship, including that historic maiden voyage, and why this group called the SS United States Conservancy is working so hard to save it. If you want to see more of the ship, we have a photo gallery online at WGAL.com.